Yo, FCFM, it's Mike Austin, man. I'm out here in Orlando, Florida. World of Game behind the camera. Yes, sir. In the back. Got a good chest workout going on right now, bro. Good push day. Let's get this work.
Mm-hmm. Locking it in here. Let's see the good work, bro.
About to fit, baby. Let's go.
Look at the boy work. All day, full range of motion. You see the titties working. Look at the contraction. Each repetition. Full extension at the elbows.
Come on.
Let's get it. Yeah, Mike. Yeah, Mike.
Yes.
Excellent work. Excellent work. There you go. There you go. Good to, especially if you, I know you're usually working out alone, you're working out with the homies, so always go a little harder because you got the extra security.
What's on the menu today, Coach Will?
Yeah, we got a little push day, a little chest, shoulders, triceps, doing some Smith machine work first, a little bit more of a bodybuilder-esque routine. As you can see, you got to get jacked like my guy over here.
Look at that boy.
Don't make no sense. and he's apparently bulking.
Yep.
Apparently.
Yeah. I've been eating enough since y'all got here. Yeah.
So you're even eating even more?
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy.
What are you eating, like 3,000 a day?
Trying at least minimum 3,000. If I can eat even more, then I'll eat more.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Shit. My macros right now are like 2,200. I've been eating more since I've been here. Yeah. Because I'm still trying to lose another 10 pounds.
Oh, I got you.
And then when I get to a solid 170,
yeah,
that's when I'm gonna get on wheel with like muscle building and stuff. Last set. Yeah, you already know. Look at that boy, man. Let's get it. Ooh, it ain't even arm day.
Nope. It ain't even arm day, bro. He's looking right. All right. Just like it. Let's get it, bro. Focus up. Easy work.
Come on.
Uh-huh.
Come on.
Big drive.
Yeah. I like that.
Yes,
and that's how you push. Maximum effort.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Tell them boys, level up.
Yeah, man. You already know, always gotta level up, baby.
Talk to me, Will. What we got, man?
Last set here. I've done so far two working sets at 225 or 6 reps. I'm gonna try one more. You know, we'll see how we're feeling. Gonna try to hopefully bust out 6. If not, just gonna work as hard as I can and get whatever I can get.
Yes. Got that 225 on the bar, man. Juicy pumps, all 2022.
It's the only way, the only way.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on, Will.
Four.
Yeah. Fight.
Yeah, one more for $1 million.
Yeah.
$1 million. It's all yours. It's
yeah,
all
let's
yours.
Get this money. Let's get this money. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Come on, man. Come on, man. Yeah.
How we do it, baby?
Last set.
Let's go.
Best
money.
Set.
Let's get it.
Let's get this work. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
That's it. Let me see you. Oh, yeah. Yep, I like it. I like it. Fight for it. Go. Fight.
Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Come on.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. Nope. Fight. Fight. Yeah. Yeah. That's how we do it, baby.
Come on, man.
And that's how you and that's how you spot, right? You don't touch until you're done fighting.
Don't touch my
don't
weight.
Don't touch that weight.
Don't touch my weight.
Good shit.
Just there for security.
FTFN, we out here, Iron Religion Gym. Me and Will stopped out in Orlando, Florida, from Maryland and New York to show AD some love for his 26th birthday. So we out here putting in this work, man. It's actually our last day here. We've been here for 5 whole days. Today's the last workout and our last day in Orlando, man. So y'all gonna see the work. Y'all gonna see us get this shit popping, brother. What's on the menu? Oh, man. Gonna do some Cuban raises. That's what it's called.
Yeah, Cuban presses. And we're gonna superset it with laterals. Gonna look to do 3 sets, 10 reps for both movements. Little rest time since we're working together. So once one is done, they'll hop right in.
Oh man, let's get this work.
But yeah, basically with the lateral head of the shoulder, with most people, you can do a lot of sets, a lot of reps, right? But the thing is, in order to really tap in with it, metabolic fatigue seems to be the best way.
That means low rest periods, right?
Yeah, just cut back the rest period. Yeah, and then you could probably do say 3 to 5 sets.
Yeah.
Same high rep range.
Gotcha.
You know, 10 or more.
Yeah.
You know, maybe superset or something like we're doing today.
Yeah.
And then
so
you'll
there's
get more
metabolic fatigue.
Yeah.
There's mechanical.
Mechanical tension. Yeah.
And mechanical is a loss of form.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So. Well, yeah. With this, we're really the lateral head responds very well to that metabolic fatigue.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
No wonder FedEx shoulders are crazy, bro. He was doing 10 sets of 15 to 20 with 30 seconds rest between each set.
What the fuck?
Lateral raises, bro.
There you go, yeah.
Yeah.
Metabolic fatigue. Watch. You start doing that, bro. Your lateral head, as if your shoulders weren't already good enough as it is. Start doing
I'm
that,
trying
bro.
Trying to cap them more.
Boom. Yeah.
Bet, let's get
start
it.
Doing that, man. Yeah. Nick, watch. Next 6 months.
This in so long, dude.
I like doing my legs extended.
I'm gonna try to shoot for 3. I'm not gonna go for a specific rep range yet.
That's fine.
These are, oh my gosh.
Bring
I even
closer.
Gotta incorporate the false grip and all that shit.
Bring them in closer.
Oh, close.
Yeah.
Just try and do a support hold.
Yeah, just do a support hold. Okay. Just hold it.
Yeah.
And just keep squeezing the chest.
There you go, hold it. Try and lock out those arms
if
you can. Yeah, it's hard, man.
I haven't done this since the Calisthenics Revolution days, bro. That was like 2 years ago. My God. One more time, bro, fuck that. I ain't no bitch. Close and lock out, right? And lock out.
Yeah.
All right, let's move.
Nice, Mike. Good.
Was better? I think that was like a good like 4 seconds. Maybe. Yeah. We'll put the rings up higher.
Yeah.
Help out with some of that support.
Yeah, we put it a little higher for round 2. He might have to jump a little bit more, but that's okay. Let's see it, bro. Bring them closer. Don't spread them out like that. There you go. Keep them there and then jump. There you go. Yeah, that's better. Yeah, Mike. Okay. Yeah, I like it. That was a good one. Keep holding. Nice. Better. Nice. Go
it's
work.
Like
my hands give out before my chest does.
There you go. That forearm
I
work.
I keep getting the fucking chicks.
Man, y'all know what happens when AD take that shirt off, bro. It's about to get real. Man, caveman mode, bro. Let's get this work. Light, light. Easy money.
Look at the lower chest. Oh my goodness. Okay, a deep burn right now. Metabolic fatigue.
You.
Look at that boy.
Yeah. That boy moving.
So I get in. Yeah, Mike.
Yeah, fam, we got a chest finisher. I've never done anything like this before, but Will says that this is prime finish for boxing and combat sports. And obviously, as you guys know, I'm into Muay Thai and MMA, but Will's got to walk me through it because I don't.
Yeah. So, if you notice right now, his stance, he has a square stance and he's using one arm at a time. So, this is a unilateral movement, meaning you're using one arm or limb at a time. So, what Mike is going to do is he doesn't have much weight here. He's gonna pull out a little bit, and what he's gonna do, maintain that square stance. He's gonna punch through, nice and smooth. Look at the chest already, mean contraction there. As you can see, he's also, because he's not rotating, he's working anti-rotational work. So this is great for boxers or, you know, any striking combat athlete that's really looking to improve their punching power and, you know, just overall just punching efficiency. And now obviously you want to do both sides. This one, definitely 8 reps or more. Try to minimize the rotation there, Mike. So you could do this two ways. You could do it minimal rotation as Mike is doing it now, or you could get a little more rotation if you're really just focusing on the obliques. But as you can see, we're really trying to emphasize the chest right now. Real good finisher there.
Bro.
Yes.
Bro. Do I have that thing or no?
That's perfect.
No, do I have the
you,
thing or no?
You have it, right?
I got the thing? Okay. I wanted to make sure I had the thing.
It's right there. Look. Get the camera closer.
I want to make sure I had that trademark.
It's right there.
Austin Dunham.
You see that right there?
Mm-hmm.
No, it's right there.
I can't get it up.
Little cleavage action.
Yeah.
Let me try the 10.
You can drop it, yeah.
I want to make sure I had that Austin Dunham. If I don't put it in, will it still...
Well, I would.
I couldn't get the 15 in.
Yeah, that's fine.
Is it pulling the 15?
Yeah. Go for
it. Nice, bro.
What are we doing?
8 to 10? 10 to 12. Maybe
more to fail here.
Nice, bro. I turn this way, right?
Yeah. So, yep, back pack, elbow up, and then as you come up, you turn it out. Yep. There you go. Nice.
God damn, dude.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I've never ever done this. Katana.
I call them katana extensions. You know, single arm overhead extension with the cable. That's a formal name. I just call them katana extensions because it sounds cooler and it's kind of what it looks like. Like pulling out that blade. Getting ready to slice some motherfucker up.
Your body is strong, but your skills are weak.
Exactly.
Oh my God, bro.
Maybe that.
I'm going to let the big boys get the posing work in, man.
Big boys posing.
Big Will. Ooh, wee. Man, while these guys get their posing in, man, FTF fam, one of my biggest goals for 2022 is to create more memories with my friends. The other day I realized that I have a lot of pictures of my friends,
but not a lot of pictures and videos of me with my friends. So that's one of my biggest goals for this year, as well as, like, you know, obviously a lot of other goals that I have in mind, whether it be financial, mentally, physically, and things like that. But that's one of the biggest ones, bro. And that's mostly what this video is about, man. It's kind of spontaneous, kind of all over the place, bro. But I'm out here with my bros, man. And I just wanted to create some memories and, you know, be able to post those and share those.